Hi there, this is Emilie de Rosenroll, the CEO of the South Island Prosperity Partnership. And today I'd just like to take a couple minutes and talk about the reopening of the economy here in BC. We've been looking around the world and there's lots of countries now experimenting with reopening, and many are doing that on a phased approach. And we're very keenly watching this because, I mean, last month alone in March, the country lost 1 million jobs. So the stakes couldn't be higher. We're really eager to open businesses back up. And at the same time, we know that if we are to do that too quickly and it's not a gradual and measured approach, we've been told that the risks of a flare-up are very high and we'll lose all of the ground that we just gained and worked so hard to win. So we need to take a measured approach. We need to do this gradually. We need to listen to the experts. And that's what we all want to do. This week, Dr. Bonnie Henry was talking to British Columbia about the idea about reopening, and which could happen in as soon as a few weeks. So what we really want to focus on then is, I'll just take her notes exactly. She said on Wednesday, she urged employers to start thinking about reopening and urging employers to do the responsible thing and think about three things. Processes to open safely, measures to keep people safe to avoid a future outbreak, and a plan in the event of an outbreak of what you should do to safely manage that situation. So, you know, I'd just like to join the voices of the Business Council of Canada and urge for a set of national standards to help businesses understand how to keep their employees safe. So a common set of guidelines in workplaces, but also in public settings like parks and universities and schools and transit, so that we all can make sure that we don't lose this ground, we don't go back to future lockdowns. So that would be something that would be great. The stakes couldn't be higher for Canadians, for British Columbians. Literally, lives and livelihoods are at stake. And we're all in this together. So if you're like me, you need a little pick-me-up. The silver lining of being locked down at home, especially as very social creatures, is the lovely drawings I get from my four-year-old. They're always quite happy in their self-isolation because their whole world is their home anyways. So here is just a little view. Oh, I won't show you that one. She's missing some clothing. Here we'll show you this one. And I hope you all have a wonderful day at home in your offices. Thank you.